Edwarde Lyttelton died 1558. Edwarde Lyttelton, or Edwarde Lyttelton by 1489-1558, was a Staffordshire landowner from the extended Littleton/Lyttelton family. He also served as soldier and Member of Parliament for Staffordshire in the House of Commons of England, the lower house of the Parliament of England, 5 times. Background and early life. Edwarde Lyttelton's father was Richard Lyttelton, a younger son of the great 15th-century jurist Thomas de Lyttelton. Richard had settled in Staffordshire, his mother's home county, and become surveyor to Edward Stafford, 3rd Duke of Buckingham. He became a tenant and probably steward of William Winsbury, who was Lord of Palatin and Otherton, in the parish of Penkridge, in the late 15th century. He inherited Baxterley, Warwickshire, from his father, but made his most important gains through marriage. Edward's mother was Alice Winsbury, William's daughter and only heir, whom Richard married. She inherited the Palatin and Otherton estates, including the moated medieval manor house of Palatin Hall, when her father died in 1502. Richard died in 1517, and she outlived him by 12 years. Only with her death did the Winsbury estates become part of the Lyttelton inheritance. Edwarde Lyttelton probably received legal training at the Inner Temple, Thomas de Lyttelton's Inn. Probably in 1512, he enlisted to serve in the campaign launched by Henry Roman VIII as part of the War of the League of Cambrai against France. In 1513, Lyttelton took part in Henry's invasion of northern France, in which his troops defeated the French at the Battle of the Spurs, going on to take the important stronghold of Tournai. Lyttelton's companion in this campaign was Sir John Giffard of Chillington Hall, near Brood, a near neighbor who distinguished himself in the fighting. It was probably Giffard who helped Lyttelton gain a number of appointments at court and locally in Staffordshire. Lyttelton himself was of greater note after Richard Lyttelton's death in 1516 left him in possession of some property. The execution of Buckingham, the most important Staffordshire magnate, in 1521 also opened up numerous lines of preferment in the county. Lyttelton was made escheator for Staffordshire during 1517-18. He was appointed gentleman usher, an important royal honor, by 1522. Around the same time, he became constable of Stafford Castle and keeper of Stafford Park, as well as bailiff of Forbridge. These honors were crowned by becoming High Sheriff of Staffordshire during 1523-24, an honor he was to repeat in 1539-40. Parliamentary career. With the death of his mother Alice in 1529, within months he was elected as the junior of Staffordshire's two Knights of the Shire, a designation for county members of Parliament that does not imply a knighthood. His senior colleague was Sir John Giffard, his near neighbor of Chillington Hall. The 1529 Parliament, known as the Reformation Parliament, assembled in November and was to last for 6.5 years. The most important measures in the early years were concerned with stripping away the privileges of the clergy, particularly those that tied them to the Pope, with whom Henry Roman VIII was in continual conflict over the proposed annulment of his marriage to Catherine of Aragon. The fifth session in 1533 dealt with the statute in restraint of appeals, forbidding all appeals to the Pope. Thomas Cromwell, the architect of the Act, listed Lyttelton and Giffard as opposed. However, he was probably generally in favor of the reformation measures. Both Giffard and Lyttelton were happy to buy and speculate in lands that came on the market as a result of the dissolution of the Lesser Monasteries Act, the most important measure of the last session of the 1529-36 Parliament. Certainly Lyttelton and Thomas Giffard, Sir John's son, were returned to Parliament by the Shire again in 1536, with the King's approval. This Parliament lasted until 1539. Lyttelton did not serve in the Parliaments of 1542, 1545, and 1547, nor in the first Parliament of 1553, which was the last of Edward VI's reign. In August 1553, Queen Mary, Henry Roman VIII's Roman Catholic daughter, summoned her first Parliament. In September, the local gentry assembled at Stafford and immediately elected Sir Thomas Giffard as their representative. Baron Stafford, Buckingham's son, had made known his intention to have his son, Henry, take up the other county seat, and had put two of his allies, Sir George Griffith and Humphrey Wells, in charge of the business. However, Littleton had fallen out with the Staffords, previously friends and allies, over fishing rights on the River Pink at Dunstan, north of Penkridge. When the young Henry was acclaimed as Giffard's colleague, Littleton intervened and demanded a poll. He persuaded the High Sheriff, George Blount, to begin the poll by examining Stafford's supporters. The latter then began to melt away, leaving Littleton to claim victory with 248 votes. Stafford petitioned the Privy Council, claiming that the sheriff had also discriminated against his son in the previous election, earlier in the year. Littleton took his case to the Lord Chancellor, Stephen Gardiner, who found in his favor. The case caused lasting ill feeling between the Staffords and Littletons. Littleton was knighted in October at the Assembly of the Parliament. Littleton seems to have accepted rather than welcomed the restoration of Catholicism in Mary's reign. As there was never a suggestion of restoring the monasteries and chantries, the gains made by the landed interest in the previous reigns were never under threat. Littleton's attitude was not warm enough to get him into the next Parliament in the spring of 1554. However, he was returned for the second Parliament of that year with his stepson, Sir Philip Draycott, as second member, and for the 1555 Parliament with Sir Thomas Giffard again. Religious beliefs. Littleton seems to have been a religious conservative, opposing the initial break with the papacy. His main associates, like the Giffards, had similar attitudes. However, none of them opposed changes that benefited the landed gentry, particularly the dissolution of the monasteries. Unlike the northern gentry, who led the Pilgrimage of Grace, a large and threatening rebellion against the dissolution, the Staffordshire gentry, not least Littleton, clamored to buy newly marketable land and houses. However, the theological conservatism remained, with a strong attachment to traditional Catholic dogma. This fitted well with Henry Roman VIII's own attitudes, but Littleton still managed to turn it to his own disadvantage. Littleton's most important intervention on a theological issue was in the case of George Blagg, at the time MP for Bedford. On 9 May 1546, Blagg was induced to deny the efficacy of the Mass by trickery, he alleged, while walking home after church. He was immediately summoned by Thomas Wriothesley, the Lord Chancellor, and sent to Newgate Prison. At his trial at the Guildhall, the main witnesses for the prosecution were Littleton and Sir Hugh Calverley, MP for Cheshire. On their evidence, Blagg was sentenced to be burned for heresy the following Wednesday. Fortunately for him, the Lord Privy Seal, John Russell, appealed on his behalf to the King, who had not heard of the proceedings to that point. Henry immediately pardoned Blagg and ordered Wriothesley to release him. The real sin of Blagg seems to have been that he was openly opposed to the influence of Thomas Howard, 3rd Duke of Norfolk, who was one of the most powerful men in the country. Blagg feared that he would exercise too much influence over the future Edwarde VI, and had said as much to Norfolk's son, Henry Howard, Earl of Surrey. It is unclear whether Blagg at that time actually held the sacramentarian views imputed to him. 5 years later, he gave evidence against Stephen Gardiner, specifically pinpointing the bishop's traditional views on the Eucharist. However, in testifying against Blagg, Littleton was acting, consciously or not, in the interests of the Howard dynasty. Henry clearly shared Blaggy's fears and soon acted against both the Howards. So Littleton's part in the case did not endear him to the king. Still less did it endear him to the subsequent regime. This is probably part of the reason he stayed away from Parliament for some years. Landowner. Littleton consolidated and enlarged his families. He was frequently involved in litigation and other disputes in his pursuit of these ends. Palatine itself, with the manor house, actually belonged to Burton Abbey, probably since about when Wulfric Spot donated land in the area. Dissolution placed overlordship in the hands of the king, and Henry Roman VIII gave it to Sir William Paget in 1546, it was to rest in the Paget family's hands for at least two centuries. However, the Littletons as terre tenants were secure in possession of Palatine. When Edwarde Lyttelton died in 1558, the rent they paid to the overlord amounted to just 16 shillings, while the estate was valued at £15. 9. Black Lady's Priory, Brood, was one of the very small houses swept away in the first round of dissolutions in 1536. Lyttelton and Thomas Giffard both petitioned the king for the right to buy the site and property. Both apparently received his consent. Lyttelton won the support of Roland Lee, the Bishop of Coventry and Lichfield. The issue went to Thomas Cromwell, who decided to sell to Giffard, who, after some negotiation, bought the site, mill, and Demesne lands, worth £7.9. 1. A year for £134.1. 8. The competition for the priory does not seem to have affected relationship between Giffard and Lyttelton adversely. Holmond Abbey in Shropshire was a much larger property, put on the market after the Second Dissolution Act of 1539. Bishop Lee supported Lyttelton in his bid to buy the abbey, and he acquired it in 1540. 2 years later, he sold it, presumably at a profit, to Roland Hill, a Shropshire-born businessman who was to become Lord Mayor of London 7 years later. In 1543, Lyttelton leased the deanery manor of Penkridge from the Collegiate Church of St. Michael and All Angels. This included everything from the site of the church itself and the canons' residential buildings to paddocks in the town and areas of arable land and pasture, most of it farmed by tenants around the town. The deanery manor had existed since the 13th century when Henry de Launders, Archbishop of Dublin and Dean of Penkridge, had acquired the manor of Penkridge at the instigation of King John and divided it into two. A smaller part, conferred on the church, was known as the deanery manor, while the remainder was placed in lay hands in the 16th century the Grevilles, who were barons Willoughby de Broke. The church was a royal peculiar which had survived since the Anglo-Saxon period. However, the deanery and college were soon abolished by the dissolution of the chantries under Edward VI in 1547. The crown conferred the deanery manor on John Dudley, Earl of Warwick, an immensely ambitious member of Edward's government. Dudley had also recently acquired Penkridge Manor itself by foreclosing on a loan from his father to the cash-strapped Grevilles. Warwick, soon to become Duke of Northumberland, inherited the deanery's legal obligations. The lease still stood and Lyttelton was able to continue exploiting the estate in return for annual rent. The assessment carried out at the dissolution in 1547 valued the college's property at £82.8 annually. It was because of his attempts to maximize the value of the deanery manor that Lyttelton got into dispute with Stafford. The latter believed that Northumberland was used as a buckler in the dispute, i.e. that his great power shielded Lyttelton when he was in the wrong. The downfall of Northumberland at the beginning of Mary's reign returned the deanery manor to the crown, but the Lyttletons continued to lease it until, in the 1580s, Lyttelton's grandson was able to buy the estate. Another acquisition, hugely important in the future to Lyttelton's family, was Teddesley Hay. This sparsely populated area was part of the Royal Forest of Cannock, sometimes not quite accurately called Cannock Chase. Cannock Chase originally referred to the bishop's hunting grounds, which were contiguous with the king's. The hay was granted to Dudley in 1550. After his execution in 1553, it reverted to the crown, but Dudley's widow, Jane Dudley, Duchess of Northumberland, was granted a life's interest in it from 1554. However, she died only a year later, and Lyttelton was able to buy the hay. 200 years later, it would become the site of a new home for the Lyttletons, Teddesley Hall. Lyttelton clearly became both rich and locally powerful through his numerous dealings. Both Palatine Hall and the parish church of St. Michael were greatly altered in the early to mid-16th century. The hall was rebuilt in typical Tudor style. The church acquired of Lyttelton family chapel in its south aisle and was partly rebuilt in perpendicular style, with impressive square tower and east windows of local sandstone. Littleton must have played a significant part in all of these changes, although some may have continued in his son's time. Contemporary assessments. When he was sued by a son of Samson Erdesic, the noted Staffordshire antiquarian, Littleton was described as a man of great lands who beareth all the rule in those parts of the shire, and is greatly friended and allied. This was intended as a criticism of Littleton. Stafford, a former friend who became his main enemy among the local magnates, described how, in his later years, after his dissembling fashion offered to have taken me by his hand, and I told him he should neither have hand or heart of me for his evil, false, and untrue report of me, to the Lord Chancellor. It appears that some contemporaries regarded Littleton as an upstart. While the local nobility and their retainers assumed a value system derived from feudal society, Littleton and other landed gentry were essentially rural entrepreneurs, making their fortunes in a profoundly changed rural economy. Marriages and family. Littleton married twice. Helen Swinerton, daughter of Humphrey Swinerton of Swinerton, was his first wife. They married before 1527, perhaps long before. They had two sons and two daughters. Isabel Wood, whose father is otherwise unknown, was his second wife. They married before April 1533. Isabel had been married twice before, firstly to Ralph Edgerton of Rhinehill, and secondly to Sir John Draycott, died May 1522 of Paintsley Hall, near Draycott. Littleton died on 10 October 1558 at Paladin Hall. He was buried in St. Michael's Church, apparently in the family chapel, and a large alabaster tomb for himself and both his wives was installed. This was later moved to the south side of the chancel, where it remains. A son by Helen Swinerton, Edwarde Lyttelton, succeeded him in his estates.